בשביל להעיף אותו משם.
גול נפש.
להגיע בשביל להעיף אותו משם.
גול נפש.
It's sure good to hear from you crazy reptiles.
But right now, we got a zap. We've got some rat soldiers on our tails.
We'll catch you later, alligators.
Talk about movies, you understand what we're talking about. Movies. MC Hammer. Mass, M is mass, C is the speed of light in a vacuum. So MC Hammer is busting the light barrier. It's trying to break a barrier, and it's a barrier between us and them. The Masons are trying to the Masons and the scientists are trying to break the barrier so that they can get in. And when they say MC Hammer can't touch this, I'm assuming at that time, it's either they're saying one of two things. Either they couldn't get out, that's why they're saying you can't touch this, it's not working, or it did work and there's nothing stopping us. I'm not sure. That song came out in what, the 90s? The early 90s? So I don't know. But just to give you an idea, they're talking in every facet of communication on high physics, period. And they do it through entertainment, and all the morons and retards all clap along and sing like a bunch of fucking mindless douchebags. And that's what they are.
Goal nefesh.
E equals MC squared. It was formulated by Albert Einstein and has meant that for nearly a century, scientists have thought that nothing can travel faster than the speed of light. That's 186,000 miles per second. But now scientists carrying out experiments in Switzerland have discovered that some tiny particles seem to break that rule.
What's so extraordinary about these findings is that they seem to challenge the foundation of our understanding of how the universe works. It was Albert Einstein, a century ago, who worked out that nothing could or should go faster than light. Well, these measurements could be wrong, or something unexpected is distorting the results, or it really is possible for light to be overtaken.
If this result is true, it would mean that we'd have to fundamentally rethink the way that the universe works. Because if you have things that can travel faster than the speed of light, it's not just space that's affected, it's time that's affected too. So things start to travel backwards in time, and all sorts of weird and wonderful effects can come out of it.
Nothing in the universe is faster than the speed of light, or is it? Scientists here at CERN in Geneva say they've discovered subatomic particles that move even faster than the universally agreed rate of 300,000 kilometers a second. Experts say the discovery is a game changer and is more significant than the discovery of radioactivity. If proven, it will blow Einstein's 1905 theory of relativity out of the water, out of the water, out of the water, out of the water. Water. The particles, technical name neutrinos, were pumped from Geneva to Italy and arrived 60 nanoseconds faster than light would have done.
imaginations, haunted our dreams. And here it is, spinning before our eyes. Saturn, named for the Roman god who reigned over a golden age of peace and harmony.
Engineer. I am live here in New York because I like things that are real. I absolutely hated my modern physics class in college and never wanted anything to do with that voodoo stuff. I absolutely hated my modern physics class in college and never wanted anything to do with that voodoo stuff.
First of all, I would like to say that I'm very happy to be here and honored for being here. Thank you so much for inviting me. I'm from Italy, as you can easily guess from my accent. And I started my career, professional career, I mean, as a physicist in the so-called astroparticle physics, which is a quite new field. It dates back to the 1985, something like this, and it's a field in connection between particle physics and astrophysics, because there is a strong connection, and neutrinos are a link between those two.
Why he's so upset, Sensei. After all, not all inventions are dangerous.
Yours are. They always blow up.
Well, that's not what I meant. Take my new transdimensional communicator, for example.
Transdimensional communicator?
Yeah, I invented it so we could stay in touch with the neutrinos.
Whoa, we haven't heard from those space dudes in ages.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's give them a shout on the transdimensional horn.
At last, neutrinos! The fun's over!
Come on, neutrinos! Let's burn ions!
Rev it up, cats! The squares are gaining on us!
Stay cool! We'll duck it behind that big space rock!
I like that much better than seeing cubes from the side. Like that much better than seeing cubes from the side.
La info, Tommy Sham.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro.
Cannon.